anything that you have done. And then the other piece is extending that forgiveness to others. Offering forgiveness. It doesn't mean that the other person is going to accept it. It's like any gift you give somebody. You give someone a gift and you hope that it's going to be used for good and they're going to enjoy it and appreciate it. And some gifts just go in the closet. It's the same sort of thing. But that forgiveness and asking for that forgiveness is freeing for us. And they can choose to be free or not to be free. But it's something that we give to ourselves in that way. That gift of forgiveness has a power to transform the world. And how do we do it? It starts with practicing with the little rocks, I think. It starts with the little things. It's hard to start with the big boulder. Especially when it feels like it's just going to come barreling out on you. But starting with the little things is a good place. Praying to God. Sometimes we're not ready to forgive somebody. But we might pray to God for that person. Pray to God for our own hearts. So we don't become like a rock. Praying. And then sharing our story. Desmond Tutu talks about that. Sharing your story. Sharing the emotions and how you feel about that. And as you share that story and share your emotions, being able to then eventually tell a different story. It's a different story that comes. And then there's a choice to be made. A choice with that relationship. Sometimes we have no choice because the person is out of our lives, they've passed on, we don't have a choice with that. But often with forgiveness, we have a choice what we're going to do with that relationship. You can choose to try to restore that relationship. And people who have lived together for many years, been friends for a long time, have often figured out how to forgive. Although sometimes I recognize that some people who live together for a long time and stay together also might just learn how to live separately. But the ones that really know how to lean on one another learn how to forgive. And sometimes what we need to do is let go of that relationship. It's an abusive one, maybe. It's not safe for you to be there. Let it go. Cut that little tether and be able to move on. Friends, sometimes it's easy and sometimes it's wretchedly hard to do it. But God is so amazing. God can transform our hearts in miraculous ways. May we accept that forgiveness and offer it to others in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
church next Sunday. Those meetings are open to the entire congregation, and all are welcome to come and stay. Also listed in the bulletin are upcoming events for Lent, and I want you to mark your calendars to join us for Palm Sunday. We're going to have a potluck here on Maundy Thursday, so come and eat and stay for worship, or come and eat, and if you have to be somewhere else, come and eat, or if you just come to worship, whichever part. Filled with love and hope and forgiveness and peace. And remember this, for some in this world, those things are strangers. May they find in us to be the most generous of friends. In the name of Jesus, amen. Let's stand and sing, Go Now in Peace.